Today we're gonna talk about one of the most popular footwear types, flat ballet shoes. There are a variety of possible designs that you can find in magazines and stores. Maybe you have these designs, but all these flat ballet shoes based on the same rules of construction. They're based on the construction of simple, classic, flat ballet shoes.
Learn how to make shoes with my step-by-step video courses.
Most of the questions that I got from you as a beginner in shoemaking are about tools and materials that you need to make this footwear type. So now let's talk about materials and tools that you need to make flat ballet shoes. As we start making our flat ballet shoes from pattern making, so let's talk first about tools and materials you will need in this step of your work. You need to have the shoelace for flat ballet shoes, masking tape, measurement tape, shoemaker's measurement tape, simple pencil, utility knife, two types of rulers, simple one and with a 90 degrees angle, compasses. To make your shoe patterns, you will need to work with cardboard. Use any cardboard type that you can find in your local store. It must be flexible and stable in the same time. And also use ordinary paper A4 to make our patterns from it to check the correctness of our basic pattern. Now let's talk about leather that you need to use for upper and lining of your flat ballet shoes. There are different types of leather for the uppers, and I advise you to work with full grain leather with thickness of 1 millimeter, 1 millimeter, 0.1 millimeter. The types that you can use for flat ballet shoes is goatskin, calfskin, sheepskin. And this is an example of sheepskin, and you see it's thin enough and not too thick, so the thickness of 1 millimeter is optimal to create women's shoes, ballet flat shoes. For lining, I use different types of leather, goatskin and pigskin, and maybe calfskin for elegant footwear types. This, for example, is goatskin. The thickness of this lining is 0.8 or 0.9 until 1 millimeter. This is the optimal thickness for lining for women's shoes. You will need to work with these two types of reinforcement tapes. White with the thickness, with the width of 14-16 millimeters, and narrow reinforcement tape with the width of 3-4 millimeters. Also, you will need to work with this silver pen to mark certain points and marks on the top, on it or inner side of our leather. It's erasable, so after you will make marks, you can easily erase it with some piece of rubber. Also, in the process of cutting, assembling and sewing, you will need to have awl, simple straight awl, and scarving knife. The type of thread is polyester thread, and number of thread for these thicknesses of upper and lining leather is 60, number 60. Okay, so all these materials you will need in the process of cutting, assembling and sewing of your upper for flat ballet shoes. Now, before you will move on to the lacing process, you will need to prepare insoles. You can make the insoles from cardboard. This is Texon cardboard, shank board, and between these two layers from which you will create your insole, you will put the steel shanks. In process of lacing, you will need to place stiffeners. So this is material that you can use for stiffeners. Non-woven chemical fabric. This is the cork sheet that you will use later when you will last your uppers to flatten the shoe bottom. These three tools are most important tools in making shoes. Shoemaking hammer that you will work with in different steps of making your flat body shoes. Pincers that you will use mostly in the process of lasting. And shoemaking rasp that you will use in many different steps of your work. Also, if you don't have rasp, you can work with Dremel, a good untraditional tool that most beginner uses in my courses. In making your flat body shoes, you will need to use these two types of nails. These short nails with big head and these long nails with flat head. It's very thin nail and long nail. We use these nails in process of lasting our front part of the upper. These nails we'll use in the process of lasting to close the back part of the upper. Also, in the entire process of making your flat body shoes, you will need to use glue. So use neoprene glue, contact glue for leather. And don't forget to work with mask and goggles for your safe work. This is leather that you can use to make your shoe soles from. This is the back part of the hide. It's very durable, but it will be flexible when you wet it during sole making. The thickness of this leather is approximately 4-5 millimeters, so when you will cut your shoe soles, you will get the shape like this, and then you will need to scuff it and prepare everything to be ready to attach this shoe sole for your flat body shoes. Now I want to stop and talk about this simple but very useful tool that you will use a lot in making flat body shoes: utility knife. To cut all your shoe uppers, cardboard, you can use this simple utility knife. What is important here, the most, is the blade that you will use. It must be very sharp, and I prefer to work with type of blade that has angle of 30 degrees. This is Japanese blade, excellent blade, BD100. To keep it always sharp, you can sharpen it, and I have a tutorial where I explain how to sharpen it. Or when you will feel that your blade already is not sharp, you can remove one part of your blade, and now you will have sharp blade again. Now, before you will start to work with this blade, with this utility knife, you need to train a little bit. Because your cardboard patterns must be very accurate. How you can train yourself easily to cut your patterns accurately? During cutting, look not on the point where you cut, but a little bit far away. For example, if I will start cut here, I will not look on this point. I look on this point that is far away from the point where I cut. And this is how you will manage very accurate cuts, curved lines, straight lines. It's a small tip, but very useful. So train yourself a little bit before you start working with your patterns to have these skills that will help you to make your patterns very accurate without any uneven surfaces with bumps. You will have perfect smooth lines on your shoe patterns, on your flat body shoe patterns. The process of making flat body shoes consists of many different steps, and I can't explain every step here in this short tutorial. But what I can do for you is to show you main steps of making flat body shoes, so you will have an idea how these shoes are done. We start from pattern making. In my opinion, this is one of the most important steps in shoemaking, and it will help you a lot in making your shoes other footwear types. So in pattern making, we start from applying the design of our flat body shoes on covered shoe last. I mean covered, we need to cover our shoe last with masking tape. And after we'll cover it with masking tape, we can apply the design of our flat body shoes. And we have to apply this simple design according to the rules of construction of these flat body shoes. I draw a line on the inner side to draw a straight line. After we will design our flat body shoes on masking tape, we need to cut it out and attach it to the cardboard. My pattern from tape on the board. After you will make your basic pattern on the cardboard, you will need to check it, because from basic pattern we'll develop all other parts of our flat body shoes, upper pattern and lining pattern. That's why it should be correct. The best way to check this basic pattern is to make a paper pattern, place it on the shoe last and see how this paper pattern lays on the shoe last. To elastic. We will look on our neckline if the line on inner side of the pattern is correct. Then comes the step of cutting, assembling and sewing of your flat body shoe upper. Decide how much you must to scarf, you can fold the edge of the upper. Before you go to last your upper on the shoe last, you need to prepare the insole. Attach exactly on the marked line. See the edges of the shank board. When your insole will be ready, you can start to last your flat ballet shoe upper on the shoe last. During lasting, you will place also stiffeners, toe puffs. I grab on the edge of the pincer and pull it. During lasting, it's very important to last both pairs of your flat ballet shoes parallel to have identical flat ballet shoes. Okay, we lasted our first pair of shoes. After you will finish lasting, you will move on to the next step, where you will make pattern of your shoe insole, will cut it from leather and will attach it to the bottom of your flat ballet shoes. Okay, we cut out only one and now we will cut the second. So, and then heel, and now I attach all. Heel making process is the next step after you will attach your shoe sole. There are different ways to create heels, traditional way and alternative way. Let's talk about traditional way. In this way you will attach heels layer by layer on the bottom of your shoe last. I begin to attach according to this line. Place the nails. After you will finish your flat ballet shoes, you will take it off from the shoe last, and this is final step of your work where you will make sock liner. First you will make pattern, then you will cut it from leather and attach it inside of your flat ballet shoes. And after it, you will have your new pair of flat ballet shoes. If you want to know more about some of the specific steps of this work, like skiving, lasting, heel making, I have a lot of tutorials on my channel, so make sure to check it out. Let's talk now about most common mistakes, problems that you, as a beginner in shoemaking, may have in making flat ballet shoes. For example, loose sides or non-identically lasted upper of your flat ballet shoes. I mean the throat line that will look differently in your right and left halves. So let's talk about this problem. So one of the most common mistakes that beginners do is making non-identical flat ballet shoes because they don't know how to last it correctly during lacing process. So now I want to show you one of the tips that will help, simple tip that will help you to create identical throat line during lacing process. In general, throat line is one of the most important lines in these simple flat ballet shoes. And I already made a tutorial how to design this line beautiful and correctly, so you can find a link to this tutorial below the video. Now, after you will design this beautiful throat line on the masking tape and we'll take it off to continue working on this paper pattern, on this masking tape pattern, make here a mark with your marker to know where is the throat line must lay during lacing process. So mark a point here or measure the distance between edge of the shoelace, the feather line of the shoelace in the toe until the throat line that you designed. So in my case, this distance will be 75 millimeters. So when I will move on to last my upper, I will mark same distance on both shoelace that I work with. So 75 millimeters here along central line and 75 millimeters also on the second half. So according to this mark that you will need to mark on both of your shoelaces, you will know how much you need to pull your uppers to reach this point. Next important thing that you may encounter with is that different leather stretches differently. So if for your prototype you will use one type of leather and for your actual upper you will use different type of leather, you may have different opening here, different depth of the throat line. But this mark in this case will help you as well, because when you start to last one of your halves and see that you can last it more because you have too stretch leather, for example, you will stretch it and you will have your opening here. It's too open, but again, it's your first pair, and to have identical pairs, you can mark same distance from the point here, and this is how you will get second half with the same depth of the throat line, of the neckline. Although it will be too open, but at least you will get identical pair, identical halves, and will have beautiful shoes, okay? That's it for the flat ballet shoes. Now, if you want to know more about some specific footwear type that you want to make or have some problems with this specific footwear type, make sure to check my other tutorials in this series. Thank you and see you in the next video.